We really have a great selection of vehicles for you to drive tomorrow. And, you know, we obviously encourage you to get in and drive them, but we really want you to also take a walk around them and look at them, because emotionally compelling design continues to pervade our vehicle lineup. And we see style now as the number one reason for purchase for a General Motors vehicle, which 5 years ago, it was just, what's the deal? So, I mean, it really is, it's really taking shape. We know you're going to enjoy yourself tomorrow, and obviously we'll be very interested in your take on the vehicles as well. Well, you know, an awful lot's happened over the past year since our collection. I don't need to tell you that when you look at the economy and certainly the impact on our industry. And to say times are tough would probably make me the master of understatement here tonight. But, you know, the industry is very slow. And, you know, we have a lot of challenges as a company. I think you read probably in the paper every day about some of the financial challenges, the liquidity challenges, et cetera. And a lot of new and different things are happening as the company transforms itself. But the one thing that we'll continue to stay focused on is building the best products in the world. And I think if you look at the products that we've launched over the last couple of years, numerous award winners, I'm going to say it again, we have great products in the market now, and the good news is the pipeline's full of more of them. So you'll get a chance to get a peek at that as well. We celebrated our 100th birthday last week, and I thought it was pretty interesting because I think Rick Wagner at the end of the conversation said, you know, we don't want to be thought of as a 100-year-old company. We want to be thinking about we're a very aggressive company that's going to go and be here 100 years from now. And we know that the competition, although I understand, I heard Ford raise the windows and wished us a happy birthday. That was probably the only break they're going to give us. And I don't think Toyota even cared. So, but you know, we're gonna prove on the playing field that we have products that can compete with everybody, and everything we do anymore is we're gonna be the best. Okay, so you know, you see General Motors North America with a number of challenges. Those of you that had an opportunity to sit through the celebration last week, is the global nature of the company is staggering. And not only are we leveraging the resources around the world to do global products, a number of the products that you'll see in our mid-sized architectures and our smaller are actually developed and engineered outside of the United States, where people are used to doing those kinds of products, but also the way we learn. And the way that we learn from the economies and the cultures that these vehicles are successful in, and that the General Motors subsidiaries are very successful in. So, but you know, we're talking about General Motors North America, and there are a lot of myths about GM, and we're certainly going to continue to try and communicate where some of that stuff isn't really true. For instance, GM is predominantly known as a truck company, and those of you that know me, I've been doing trucks, and so I'm pretty proud of that. We're really known as trucks, but in the category of no good deed goes unpunished, you know, we've also become probably known as only a truck company, and it's kind of overshadowed the successes that we've had in cars, particularly in the area of fuel economy. As a matter of fact, when you look at the reality of the situation, GM has more vehicles that get over 30 miles per gallon highway than anybody else. There's about 18 of those models, and 15 of those are not hybrids. So, you know, a very affordable mix. Those of you that know, one of our key points on doing the trucks is our trucks were designed to be the best in fuel economy, and you'll see some further discussion that we have done some things to continue to build on that lead. You know, we're not standing still in what we'll call the alternative and advanced propulsion systems either. We introduced our two-mode hybrids on the trucks here this past year. in the company. We have five hybrid vehicles, total hybrid vehicles in the market now. In 4 years, we'll have 20. So we're not standing still. We continue to escalate how we're doing. You'll have a chance tomorrow to drive a hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. We have 100 vehicles out in customers' hands right now in some selected major metro areas where people are actually experiencing driving these vehicles, they're refueling them, and they're giving us their feedback. And then, of course, you know, no conversation is going to end without talking about what I'll say the halo vehicle the company is. Kind of the headline, and that's a Chevy Bolt, and we'll talk a little more about that later. But it really does represent, you know, what we call the electrification and basically the reinvention of the automobile. But the folks that let me do this said, okay, you've been doing trucks, so you can talk about trucks first. So I will. You know, Texas, and certainly a lot of the South Central and Southeast regions really represent some very strong markets for us in trucks. And actually in 2007, Chevrolet actually outsold Ford in Texas for the first time. And our retail sales of our pickup trucks have really continued to build momentum through time. So, you know, I'll be the first one probably to raise my hand and say I think the reports of our death are a bit premature here. The segment's down. It's still a very important segment. We know that there will always be customers who need these trucks, who need the capability of these trucks, and they love these trucks. And so it's our responsibility to continue to make these trucks more efficient and more responsible citizens in the environment that they operate in. Nationally, we remain number one. It's an honor, and we take it very seriously every day that the customer rewards you with their purchase. It's not a given right. It's something that you're fighting with everyone every day on. And we have an over 40 share in the pickup market with five other competitors. And our SUV sales are actually over 60%. So not something we take lightly. We work hard every day to build on that. The trucks are capable, and one of the key measures now, and I believe in some of the press releases, fuel economy now is the number three reason for purchase on pickup trucks, where it used to be in top 10 something, top 50, I believe top 10, excuse me. Well, what we've done is taken some of the parts we've had, and we actually have a new, what we call XFE model on our pickups. We also are introducing more hybrids, and we actually have more six-speed applications with our V8s. The XFE rollout in 09 includes two-wheel drive versions of our Silverado and Sierra pickups, as well as our Yukon and Tahoe utilities. And at a 15 city and 21 EPA highway mileage, that is the best in the industry. Actually, that's about 3 to 4 miles per gallon better highway than a Toyota Tundra, and 3 to 4 miles per gallon better than a Ford Expedition in city and highway. So we continue to want to roll out the best products for our customers. We achieve these improvements really by kind of going into our parts bin. We put a 308 rear axle in there, 6-speed automatic. We learned about some good low rolling resistance tires from our hybrid program, and also improved aerodynamics from that program. We use our aluminum block flex fuel 5.3 liter with our active fuel management as well. So we take the pieces and parts that we've had before, and we integrate them into a package, and we try and come up with yet further improved fuel economy. Our full-size hybrid SUVs are industry leaders in fuel economy at 21 city and 22 highway on two-wheel drives. That is the same city mileage as a four-cylinder Toyota Camry, but you can put eight vehicles in there, and, you know, or eight vehicles. You can put eight people in there, and Madeline, maybe we could put your eight vehicles in there. So, but, you know, talk about Mythbusters, you know, the Toyota was named the green car of the year. So, you know, you can have myth busting good ways and bad ways. We have the Escalade hybrid is now in the market, and the Sierra and Silverado are coming shortly after the first of the year. So again, maintain all of the capabilities of the full-size truck, and also offer some significantly improved fuel economy and lower operating costs. Okay, so that was six slides. I'm done talking about trucks. How about that? Okay, let's talk some cars and crossovers. 11 of the last 13 vehicle launches at General Motors have been cars and crossovers. And a lot of those vehicles have been significant award winners. Car of the year, at the auto shows, Motor Trend, those kinds of car and driver, those kinds of things. So you can see this momentum starting to build. In addition, 18 of our next 19 launches will also be cars and crossovers. And just to show you some examples here, some things that you'll get to drive tomorrow. Here's the 2009 Chevy Malibu, and we've taken a 6-speed automatic with a 4-cylinder engine. And at 33 miles per gallon, that's 2 miles per gallon better than a 4-cylinder Camry or Accord non-hybrid. And it's also going to be available in the Saturnora. Another example is our XFE on the Chevy Cobalt and the Pontiac G5, and that's rated at 37 miles per gallon highway. Now, not only does that beat the Corolla and the Civic, which are in that same class, but it also beats the Yaris and the Honda Fit, which are even smaller. So again, the fuel economy story is good, and we need to continue to communicate and reinforce that we do have these products and we do have these models. And an awful lot of the dialogue here with you and your driving impressions is to show your readership that we really do have these products out there. You know, our new crossovers, our full-size crossovers, starting with the Saturn Outlook, the GMC Acadia, the Buick Enclave, and now joined by the Chevy Traverse, and I think Jill's going to show you a little bit about that tomorrow, are unsurpassed in their fuel economy. And I'm not going to take the story away from Jill, but the Traverse goes on sale this fall. And it's got a lot of great cues from the Malibu and its styling, its interior craftsmanship, et cetera. And it's got some pretty impressive cruising range numbers, and I think you're going to talk about that tomorrow, Jill, so stay on the edge of your seats. It also offers a very full selection, like most of our products, of safety features like StabiliTrack, 6 airbags, non-star, Bluetooth connectivity, and a host of other features. And so, while performance and fuel economy are very, very important, we talked a little earlier about this emotionally compelling design. And, there are some great examples of that have been recently launched, to wit the Buick Enclave. You know, the Buick Enclave is bringing Buick buyers in that we never even dreamed would happen. I mean, it's unbelievable. So it reinforces this brand of what Buick is all about. And you'll see that in the next cars, the next LaCrosse, the next Lucerne, et cetera. Cadillac CTS, that was on everybody's win list as a car of the year. It's doing very, very well in a market that arguably is not the best market at this point. And of course, the Chevy Malibu that was launched here a little over a year ago. Sales are very strong, up in double and triple percentage numbers. And it pretty much is a vehicle that people see as kind of the change agent in General Motors. Here's a vehicle that's very affordable and has a very richly crafted interior, very emotionally compelling design, great fuel economy, great noise and vibration characteristics. So it's like, we finally put it all together, and here we go. Tomorrow you're going to get to see and drive a couple new things. You're going to see the Pontiac Solstice Coupe. You're not going to get to drive this, which is too bad because it's really hot, and this G8 Sport truck. And although it won't be here tomorrow, the upcoming Opel Insignia. Now, this was launched over in Europe, I believe, a month or so ago. But this vehicle is basically the foundation for all the mid-sized cars that will be coming into North America over the next few years. So it's a terrific vehicle. I mean, dynamically, styling, craftsmanship, those kinds of things. So, we've obviously seen this shift to cars, and it's been a very abrupt and rapid one here. And I think a lot of us inside the company feel that this is a shift that's here to stay, and we're very well prepared, as I mentioned, with all the products we do have in the pipeline coming forward. The one thing that I'd say, again, that we learned globally, again, we leverage the resources, but we also learn, is smaller vehicles everywhere else in the world are very, very well equipped, very luxurious, very highly contented vehicles. And in North America, I don't think that we had that same paradigm. So great opportunity for us to learn and catch up. People do want vehicles that are well contented. They might not need all that size anymore. They want to be safe. They want to have all the conveniences. So this is a great opportunity for us to capitalize on all the learnings that we have from all over the world. Okay, no conversation with you folks would ever be complete without talking about where we are going in terms of helping the world get, I'll say, oil independence, certainly here, reducing greenhouse gases, etc. So, General Motors is not standing still. We know that having what we have out there now isn't enough. We've got to continue to get better. We've got to continue to outpace our competition. We are pursuing a number of paths. I don't think that there's any one silver bullet to this whole thing. So you will see that we have a number of alternative approaches, all of which have the same end goal. That's reducing greenhouse gases, improving fuel economy, and displacing petroleum through energy diversity. It starts with just the blocking and tackling, improving the efficiency of our internal combustion engines. You'll see our homogeneous charge compression ignition technology, which is kind of combining the benefits of a gas and diesel with auto ignition, with about a 15% fuel savings that'll be coming forward. We continue to improve diesels, and obviously a lot of the after-treatment programs are going to continue to give us the balance of offering the best fuel economy and performance at lower costs. Ethanol and E85, I had a great conversation with Vivian and Fernando here tonight about Brazil and sugarcane. And, I know E85 is kind of an emotional subject. We have over 3 million vehicles on the road today that are E85 capable or flex vehicle capable, and we'll have another 1.5 million in another 2 years. We need to get the emotion out of the ethanol equation. That's how its impact on the food chain, and we're working with Cascada and Mascoma to develop the cellulosic ethanol, which uses leaves, stalks, corn stalks, things that are ground up today in the making of ethanol. So it'll be significantly less expensive to produce. And again, alternate fuels continue to provide another approach to reducing our energy dependence. We talked about hybrids earlier. They are very important. I mentioned that we'll quadruple the number of hybrids that we offer in the market by the year 2012. And it's interesting, hybrids are not only catching attention here in North America, but also in a global company. We're seeing interest in hybrids in a number of the Asian markets and in the Middle East as well. You can see here an example of Buick LaCrosse Eco Hybrid that will be coming out in China later this year. Going beyond the conventional hybrids, we will have a plug-in hybrid. It's a Saturn View. It's going to feature lithium-ion batteries, and it's going to double the fuel economy of any SUV on the market out there. Once you get past the hybrids, the next step, we are doing this testing on our fuel cell vehicles. I talked about Project Driveway out there. You're going to get a chance to drive that vehicle tomorrow and experience that. But when you take all of those initiatives, the real headline, of course, is the Chevy Bolt. And a lot of people called this our moonshot. I thought doing the two-mode hybrid was our moonshot. I thought this was more like Mars, whatever. But this is really the real deal. I mean, it is unbelievable. Last week, and I guess in some internet sites, maybe a little earlier than that, it was unveiled. And it's going to go on sale in a little over 2 years from now. Up to 40 miles of gasoline and emissions-free electric driving. And for those of you that have been living in a cave someplace, you know, 75% of all the daily commutes are 40 miles or less. So arguably somebody could use this vehicle and never run it on gasoline. So pretty interesting. Does have extended range capability. The main propulsion system is all electric, as opposed to today where you have an electric system supplanting an internal combustion engine. It's the other way around. There will be a power source that will continue to keep the batteries charged and keep the electric motors running. Are you going to get a chance to see this this vehicle tomorrow? You know, a lot of interesting displays. Obviously not going to drive it tomorrow, but I believe you're going to get to look in the back. Craig, I guess somebody's peeked. Yeah, you get to look in through the back. So you'll see things like the liquid crystal displays, the nav screens, the infotainment controls, etc. So the interesting thing on this vehicle, again, is you plug this into the wall to recharge it. At this point, they feel it's going to cost 1 to 2 cents a mile, which would be about 80 cents a day to do your 40-mile commute. They say that's less expensive to charge than your home refrigerator. I guess that depends on how cold you keep your beer, but it still, you know, is a pretty interesting change and switch in the market. So, you know, you're seeing a lot of the new automotive DNA here, and this vehicle and a number of the others are really reinventing the automobile, transforming GM and the entire industry. And, you know, we do have the resources and we have a plan to win, and we've got the products here. You know, we talk about the proof being in our products, and, you know, we have a number of award winners in the market today. The market is rewarding us with improved sales performance, improved retail experiences, and like I said, these 18 and 19, we're taking all the learnings we've had, and you're going to see some more award winners in the pipeline. It's full of them. You know, we lead in fuel economy. We said we have 18 miles over 30 miles per gallon. We're not stopping there. We continue to take the assault. And, you know, leading, I'd say, in energy dependence. We talked about alternative fuels, improved efficiencies in the vehicles we have today, our hybrid lineup, our fuel cells, and obviously the Volt.